The youths are claimed to be the future leaders because of the crucial role they play in political and social development of any nation. They serve as the building block that links the past with the present. They also represent the future hope of every society. The survival of any political system depends on the role of the youth in participatory democratic platform, which allows all groups, regardless of their position, to participate, articulate and negotiate the interest of national unity. Joining us to talk on this is Elder John Egerua, social advocate, entrepreneur and political founder, Bond Primitive Initiative. Thank you very much for joining us on the news.
Thank you so much, and I appreciate for having me.
You're welcome. The youths are touted to be the game changers in Nigerian politics, but are the predictions matched with signs of a rising to the challenge of this situation?
Yes, I will say yes, because we actually have been on the move. I would not want to support the fact that the youths are not ready. A lot of youths today, like I know, are really working, and have been working behind the scene. There's really no political party today that you see that you don't have the cadres of the youth right there. Whether they're holding positions for now, that's not the problem. The major thing is a lot of us are warming up, getting ready to take up the leadership strides. And you also understand with me that there's a place for training and learning. So that's what we are doing. So a lot of youths are getting informed, and they are actually participating. And let me say this to you. From where I came from, in Nigeria, my local government party chairman is a youth, Leslie Ebosoje, and he's actually leading the party very, very well. So a lot of youth out there are up to the game this time.
But there are concerns that why the Nigerian youth seem very creative when it comes to the entertainment industry, and even on the tech scene, they apparently are apathetic, so to speak, when it comes to politics.
Yes, the reason is because the entertainment industry is like a free, open enterprise market. Anybody can go in right there and do a lot of stuff. You don't need too much of a mentorship or what have you, or let's say finance, to get into the entertainment industry. Even from your bedroom, you can do a video and boom, you are up in the social media. People start, you start trending, right? But politics is different. The politics has a wide range of people occupying the space, right? So the opportunities available for politicians or in the political cycle are really, really different from every other field, right? So people going to politics should not really be seen as occupying space, as in positions, as governors, senators, and House of Assembly, as the rest, but be actively involved and be part of the decision makers. And I think a lot of us are doing that. But I think the other industries, as you just highlighted, we have a lot of youth over there compared to the politicking, as the case may be.
Yeah. There seems to be a lot of complaint about, you know, having the wrong people in power, the older generation even. But they also seem to show a lack of support for newcomers on the political scene, as in the last election. Why do you think this is?
You see, nobody is going to give us the space. Nobody is going to give the youth and say, ah, hey, you come. This is your position. You got to fight for it. Nothing good comes easy. Right? And the leaders that are still there today, they are still there because we're yet to make that full decision. I would say we are not ready in the sense that if we're not ready to really pull a strike to whatever we want. A lot of us are advocating for it. We say more of it than we want to do. Okay? But so we still have our leaders there, our fathers. But my point is, I said something on an interview earlier this month, on the 6th of June, and someone asked the same question, something like this, and I said, take them out of the line. And how are we going to do that? I said, key them all. It was fun, right? I said, how are you going to key everybody for the youth to enter, to come into it? And I said, strategically, we can pull up the crowd. We have the largest numbers, right, in the demographic of the nation. So if we actually have the same mindset, trust me, we can do what we want to do.
But a lack of togetherness is always obvious. You see young people coming out, and then even young people don't seem to be supporting them. How can we tweak that psyche so that more young people will support young people when they come out, other than pull them down?
Yes, the reason for that, I would say, is this. We have few guys up there who are occupying positions today. What have they done, or what are they doing? Some of them have let us down, right? And after all of the mobilization, they get there and do their own bits, their personal interests. So it's not as if the youth are not even in the offices now, as we are saying. But a lot of them goes there for their own personal interests, right? So if they come again and you are saying, because of the youth, so vote for me, people are going to like say, why are we going to follow you? Because the ones we just supported are not doing anything, right? But I just still want to say this, that irrespective of the pros from the both sides, nobody is going to give you that space entirely, right? There is no space for anyone. You got to create a room for yourself, right? How are you going to do that? It's going to be strategic, through doggedness, through a high spirit, motivated spirit at all time. Nobody's going to call you and say, come and stay here, right? Just as the Bible said. He said, see he a man who is diligent in his business, for he shall sit with kings and queens. Right? You have to be diligent. We have to be up and doing in our own games.
All right.
So that we can probably create a niche for ourselves.
All right. In spite of the disillusionment felt by many as regards the pre-election drama playing out in Edo State with Obaseki and Oshomole of the APC, there is a sense in which the options are still limited to the two established parties and career politicians. Do you hold any hope that Edo State might be the start of a true political change?
First, I think the delusion is not between Oshomole and Obaseki. It's between Izeyamo and Obaseki. Let's get that straight, right? Oshomole just being used as a bait right here. He has done his bit. He's not asking for 10-10. Whosoever is projecting him as a figure to destabilize the political setting, that's their own kind of game, right? Then back to the question. You see, we have two parties in Nigeria as it is today, and also prevailing itself in Edo State as we speak. And I asked a question this morning. I said, what is actually the difference between the PDP and the APC? There's really no clear-cut ideological difference between both of them. So that's why we keep seeing the political drama moving from the left to the right. Those who were in PDP said APC are evil. Today they are in APC. And those who were in APC yesterday just moved and said PDP is not at home. So it's a kind of, it's an issue that we need to set aside and treat accordingly. Otherwise, we're not able to fight our way through. And now, Edo State is always a decider, just as a motto, the heartbeat of the nation. Things starts from Edo State, even from the Westminster State, right? So things like this is happening today in Edo State. It's going to be a trend all through. Like the popular song that you say, Obaseki is not Ambode, and Edo is not Lagos. And from the look of things, the governor is proving his point that Obaseki is not Ambode, is not going to walk away the way Ambode just walked away. So I see this as a trend that's going to be a follow-up, especially even from the Ondo State that we'll be expecting, that governors will not just want to pull off because their godfather or their party member said they don't want them anymore. They want to fight to the least or to the
last.
All
right, John.
So, yeah.
I'm afraid that's the much time will permit us. But thank you very much for shedding some light on the conversation.
Thank you for having me. Okay.